हेलो नमस्कार एंड आदाब टू ऑल माय फ्रेंड्स फ्रॉम योर फ्रेंड एस्ट्रोलॉजर एंड गाइड इरफान वंस मोर विद यू फ्रॉम योर वेरी ओन चैनल एस्ट्रो एश्योरेंस. वन ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग्स दैट गिव्स अस रिजल्ट्स इन आवर लाइव्स इज द दशा पीरियड एंड व्हेन इम्पॉर्टेंट दशा अंतर दशा एंड द प्रत्यंतर दशा इज ऑन. हाउएवर द ट्रांजिट्स आर कॉल्ड द डिलीवरी बॉय ऑफ गिविंग अस रिजल्ट्स एंड द ट्रांजिट्स ऑफ बेनिफिट्स over their natal positions or over Kendra houses are supposed to bring good results. However, the transit of malefics are supposed to bring you challenges and issues, especially if they are transiting over the inimical signs to them. Benefic planets will still bring some benefit results even when transiting over inimical planets. However, there may also be challenges. But the transits over of malefic planets over various houses will bring a different flavor of results based on how they are placed and what results they are capable of bringing based on their characteristics, their karakas. So let's do a dive into how malefics can bring you different kinds of results based on where they are transiting over. Now a simple thing, whenever malefics are transiting over Kendra houses, there the native has less control on how the malefic planet will manifest, and to overcome the negative tendencies that a malefic planet will bring when transiting over Kendra houses, then the native will have to work much more harder. However, malefics transiting over the trine houses is better for a native because the native has more control over the what he or she can do, how the different behaviors that they can bring about in their lifestyle, what attitude they showcase, basis those they will also be able to control the results of the malefics when malefics are transiting over the trine houses. However, malefics are supposed to bring you best results when they are transiting over the upachaya houses, especially if the upachaya houses are also friendly to them. Even when the upachaya houses are inimical or unfriendly to them, yet the malefics will give you slightly lesser challenges than when they transit over the Kendra houses. Then the other thing is, when malefics transit over their own natal positions, it's a different result. They tend to bring good results. But when planets transit over their own natal positions in the birth chart, for larger planets like Saturn, Jupiter, Rahu and Ketu, by larger I mean who have a longer transit period, Saturn will come back to its own natal position roughly after 28 and a half years. So when you are born, for Saturn to get back to its position, it will take about 28 and a half years. Jupiter will come back to that position every 12 years. Rahu and Ketu will come back to the same position once every 18 years. So because these transit periods are long and they take long period of time to come back to their natal position, so a malefic planet coming back to its natal position, especially Saturn, Rahu and Ketu, is a very karmic event also, and it irrespective of whether it's an inimical sign or benefic sign that they are placed in, the results will come much more upheaval bringing or issues bringing or challenges bringing or benefic bringing also, based on how you have learned the lesson which the planet is expected to teach you and through its various manifestations regularly and what you have done about those lessons. So for example, if Saturn is in the Lagna and it's passing over the Lagna after 28 and a half years, if you have not done what Saturn expects you to do, being committed, being loyal, being dutiful, somebody who works hard, if you have not done any of it, then when Saturn comes back to its natal position, then there will definitely be some upheaval that Saturn will also bring you, some challenges that Saturn will also bring you, some shake up that Saturn will also bring you, in terms of then at least now learn the lesson through this upheaval, and that could be larger lesson than when Saturn was transiting over the other houses. So one needs to remember that the transits of Saturn, Rahu and Ketu, which take a lot of time to come back to their natal positions, which are also called the return positions, will be much more upheaval bringing or shake up position at least. Whether it's upheavals or not, it's a secondary thing. But upheavals in terms of both good and bad results will surely come through. Jupiter will bring you more benefic results, but Jupiter also expects you to have learned some lessons. I have already done videos on the return of Saturn, Rahu, Ketu and Jupiter, I would advise you to go and check those videos, what return positions of these planets or their natal positions mean. However, for the planets which have shorter transitory period, like Sun comes back to its natal position once a year, and other planets take a few months in transit, and they also come back between 8 to 9 months to 1.5 years maximum to their natal position. Moon is much faster; it comes back to its natal position every 28 or 30 days. So, Moon brings a different kind of upheaval than the others. But today we are talking about malefic planets. So, the malefic planets are Saturn, Rahu, and Ketu, and apart from those two, these three, Sun and Mars. So, transits of malefic planets, whether longer time period, Saturn, Rahu or Ketu or Sun and Mars, will surely bring up some shake up in your life. Let's look up into one example. Let's take the example of Libra ascendant native, where Saturn gets exalted in the Lagna and also becomes a Yoga Karaka, and see how the transit of Saturn over Libra ascendant native can bring different results. Let's say in the natal position or in the Lagna chart or the birth chart of a native, these are the placements of the malefic planets. Saturn is in the Lagna, Rahu and Ketu are in the 11th house and the 5th house respectively, Mars is in its own sign of Aries in the 7th house, and Sun is in Gemini. Now we know that the placement of Saturn is in exaltation sign, whereas Mars is in its own sign and a very powerful position in the Kendra house, though it has less directional strength. Sun is going over a inimical sign of Gemini, and so it is not very well placed. Rahu is in an Upachaya house in the sign of Leo, strongly placed, whereas Ketu is in the 5th house, which is again a strong placement for Ketu, because Rahu and Ketu, the nodes do well in the trine houses. So if Saturn is transiting over its natal position in the Lagna, then Saturn will bring excellent results, especially because it is also passing over its exaltation sign. If Saturn was passing over any of its other two signs as well, Capricorn or Aquarius, in any of the Kendra houses, then it would have also brought in very good results. However, if Saturn was passing over the Lagna over an inimical sign to itself, then obviously it would have brought more challenges, though passing over its natal position also means Saturn will come back to a return position, and so upheavals can be both challenging as well as benefic ones, depending on whether the sign is a friendly sign or not. Here, because Saturn is passing over Libra, which is an exaltation sign, obviously much better results will come in, and gains in reputation, steadiness and stability in life will also come in. If Saturn was passing over Ketu in the 5th house, then this is a change bringing position, because now Saturn is passing over Ketu, which is a change, harbinger of change, and Saturn is a slow moving planet. So Saturn will create a change when it is passing over Ketu. However, this change can be a stability bringing change. So the upheaval surely be there. It could be in the career of the person, because Ketu is placed 8th from the 10th house. So when Saturn is passing over Ketu in the 5th house, it could bring in a change either in the results of career, or if it's an artist, how the person performed, or in his investments, or also in his education. However, the change, once that change happens, a major change happens. This is Saturn's transit over Ketu in the 5th house, is a major change bringing position. Then after that, there will be more stability and steadiness in the results of that house. However, if Saturn is passing over the 7th house, another Kendra house, but over Mars, then Saturn will bring much bigger challenging place results, because Saturn is one, passing over its inimical planet to itself, which is Mars. Second, it is passing over its sign of debilitation, because Saturn gets debilitated in Aries. So here challenges in the manifestation of the house. So here relationships, partnerships, working with teams, working with others on a day-to-day basis, how you work with others will get affected. And while Saturn will be in this house for 2.5 years, upheavals, issues and challenges will surely come through. If Saturn was not passing over Mars and Mars was not here, but it was passing over an empty 7th house, which is Aries, then to Saturn would have brought challenges and issues. However, when it is passing over Mars, then there could also be aggression and domestic violence or violence with partners, heated arguments and heated exchanges, and over those next 2.5 years while Saturn remains in this house. So care needs to be taken about this. Saturn passing over the 8th house is always good because Saturn is the Karaka of the 6th house, the 8th house and the 12th house. However, if Saturn was passing over the 9th house over Sun, and Sun, because it is inimical to it, however, Saturn is passing over a friendly sign, which is Gemini. So your mixed results would come in, but still leadership issues, issues in higher learning, issues with gurus, issues in traveling, long distance travel will surely come up while Saturn is passing for 2.5 years with this. Saturn with Rahu creates the very strong Shrapik dosh. So issues with social connections, issues with society, issues in working with large organizations will come in, issues with friends may also come in, issues with two elder brother or with elder brother will also come in, because Saturn is both passing over Rahu, which is in a Shrapik dosh with Saturn, and over an inimical sign to itself, which is Leo. However, if some other planet was transiting over it, for example, if Sun, because it takes just over a year to go through the entire zodiac over the horoscope, then Sun passes over the Lagna over an inimical Saturn to it, then it will bring issues and challenges to the leadership position of Saturn of the native. If Sun is passing over Ketu over the 5th house, but Sun is a natural ruler of the 5th house, so Sun will retain some strength, but again a big change, upheaval bringing change will come in. Here the upheaval could be for good, because 8th to the 10th house of career means here a leadership position may also come in for the Sun, because it is retaining some of its strength. So Ketu will push for change and a jump up in leadership position and the management role may also come to the native. So friends, whenever you see transit of planets over inimical planets to themselves or over their natal positions, one should be a little careful of how you're looking at results and whether you have learned the lesson of that particular planet, the karakas of the planet, what it is signifying, what it stands for, what attitude it expects you to showcase. Saturn expects you to showcase an attitude of commitment, of loyalty, of hard working, of humility. If you have shown this, then Saturn, when it is passing over inimical signs, will bring more lesser damages to you and more benefit results, especially if it's passing over a friendly sign. However, over inimical planets, definitely there will be more issues. Other thing is, if it's an Argala position, I have made a video on Argala also, please go and watch that. Then too, issues may come in if it is passing over a Virodh Argala, but if it's passing over a friendly sign in an Argala position, then it will definitely bring you gains. So watch that Argala video for more clarity on it, because it's slightly a technical subject. So friends, look into your own horoscopes, and we have had the transit of Rahu and Ketu last month, and Saturn has transited this January into Capricorn. So see how these three planets transitions have brought about, what kind of results they have brought about, whether they have brought about upheavals or challenges to you, and if they have brought in good news to you and good gains to you, then to check what is the reason. If they have brought about some challenges, issues to you, now that Ketu and Rahu have also transited more, almost over a month now into Taurus for Rahu and Scorpio for Ketu. So see what kind of results they have brought in or opportunities they have brought in, and plan yourselves accordingly before a transit happens, so that you can be aware of if negative results are coming in and you can benefit from if benefit results are coming in, because of how you have prepared and how you have learned to face that transit. So friends, like this video, share this video, and if you're looking for a personal consultation from me, reach out to me, the link is given below. Until some other time with some other video, this is your friend, astrologer and guide Irfan, signing off. Ciao.